A fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, no? But in our little village of Anatevka, you might say, every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? We stay because Anatevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That, I can tell you in one word, tradition. Tradition, tradition. Tradition, tradition, tradition. Tradition. Because of our traditions, we've kept our balance for many years. Here in Anatevka, we have our traditions for everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to work, even how to wear clothes. For instance, we always keep our heads covered. We wear these little prayer shawls. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know. But it's a tradition. Because of our traditions, everyone here knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
Whole day and night must scramble for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers. And who has the right as master of the house to have the final word at home? The papa! She's pretty. The sun, the sun. Tradition. The sun.
In the circle of our little village, we've always had our many special types. For instance, Yenta the matchmaker.
Avram, I have a perfect match for your son, a wonderful girl.
Who is it?
Rachel, the shoemaker's daughter.
Rachel? She can hardly see. She's almost blind.
Tell the truth, Avram. Is your son so much to look at? The way she sees and the way he looks, it's a perfect match.
And Reb Nochem, the beggar.
Alms for the poor. Alms for the poor.
Here, Reb Nochem, here's one kopeck.
One kopeck? Last week you gave me two kopecks.
I had a bad week.
So, if you had a bad week, why should I suffer?
And most important, our beloved rabbi.
Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing for the Tsar?
A blessing for the Tsar, of course. May God bless and keep the Tsar far away from us.
Among ourselves, we've always gotten along perfectly well. Of course, there was a time he sold him a horse, but delivered a mule. But that's all settled. Now we live in simple peace and harmony.
It was a horse.
It was a mule.
It was a horse.
It was a mule. I tell you.
It was a horse.
Oh.
It was
a mule. Tradition, tradition. Without our traditions, our life would be as shaky as a fiddler on the roof.
I wonder if Yenta the matchmaker found a husband for you.
Oh, Yenta, Yenta, Yenta.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me your ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see.
For Papa, make him a scholar.
For Mama, make him rich as a king.
For me, well, I wouldn't holler if he were as handsome as anything. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone, so find me a match of my own.
Since when are you interested in a match, Chava? I thought you just had your eye on your books. And you have your eye on the rabbi's son.
Well, why not? We have only one rabbi. He has only one son. Why shouldn't I want the best?
Because you're a girl from a poor family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take. Right? Of course, right. Hoddle, oh Hoddle, have I made a match for you? He's handsome, he's young. All right, he's 62, but he's a nice man, a good catch. True? True. I promise you'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what. Chava, I found him. Will you be a lucky bride? He's handsome, he's tall. That is from side to side, but he's a nice man, a good catch, right? Right. You heard he has a temper. He'll beat you every night, but only when he's sober. So you're all right. Did you think you'd get a prince? Well, I do the best I can. With no dowry, no money, no family background, be glad you got a man.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, you know that I'm still very young. Please take your time.
Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could get stuck for good. Dear Yenta, see that he's gentle. Remember, you were also a bride. It's not that I'm sentimental. It's just that I'm terrified.
Matchmaker, matchmaker.
Dear God, you made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, that it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune? If I were a rich man, all day long I'd biddy biddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a biddy biddy rich, idle diddle 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 man, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with a real wooden floors below. There couldn't be one long staircase just going up and one even longer coming down. And one more leading nowhere just for show. I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each loud will land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say here lives a wealthy man. Oh, if I were a rich man, all day long I'd biddy biddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a biddy biddy rich, idle diddle 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 man, I see my wife, my Goldie, looking like a rich man's wife with a proper double chin, supervising meals to our heart's delight. I see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important men in town will come to fawn on me. They will ask me to advise them like a Solomon the wise. If you please, Reb Tevye, pardon me, Reb Tevye, posing problems that would cross a rabbi's eyes. And it won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in a synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the Eastern Wall. And I discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. That would be the sweetest thing of all. Oh, if I were a rich man, all day long I'd biddy biddy bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Lord, who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan if I want a wealthy man?
and defend you. May he always shield you from shame. May you come to be in Israel a shining name. May you be like Ruth and like Esther. May you be deserving of praise. Strengthen them, O Lord, and keep them from the stranger's ways. May God bless you and grant you long life. May the Lord protect and defend you. May the Lord preserve you from pain. Favor the Lord with happiness and peace. Oh, hear us and
here's to our prosperity, our good health and happiness, and most important, to life, l'chaim, 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 to life. Here's to the father I try to be.
Here's to my bride-to-be.
Drink l'chaim, to life, l'chaim, 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 to life. Life has a way of confusing us,
blessing and bruising us.
Drink l'chaim to life. God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie panting on the floor.
How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for?
To life, l'chaim. To title my daughter,
my wife. It gives you something to think about,
something to drink about. Drink l'chaim to life.
Reb Mordechai.
Yes, Lazer, what?
Drinks for everybody.
What's the occasion?
I'm taking myself a bride.
Who is it?
Tevye's eldest psych.
To Lazer Wolf.
To Tevye.
To title your daughter,
my wife.
May all your futures be pleasant ones, not like our present ones. Drink l'chaim to life, l'chaim.
L'chaim, time to consume
the wine. L'chaim to life. It takes a wedding to make us say, let's live another day. Drink l'chaim to life. We'll raise a glass and sip a drop of schnapps in honor of the great good luck that favored you. Favors to such men, it stands to reason we deserve it too. To us and our good fortune, be happy, be healthy, long life. And if our good fortune ever comes, here's to whatever comes. Drink the higher.
Yeah. your choice. May you live to see a thousand reasons to rejoice. Come on.
It was a miracle. It was a miracle! Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown, but like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When Moses softened Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles led him to the promised land. When David slew Goliath, yes, that was a miracle. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought could never be. God has given you to me.
What's the matter with you? Why are you howling like that?
Where is she? Where is she?
Where is who? What are you talking about?
Firma Sarah, the butcher's first wife. She was standing there a minute ago.
What's the matter with you, Tevye? Firma Sarah's been dead for years. You must have been dreaming. Tell me what you dreamed and I'll tell you what it meant.
All right. Only don't be frightened.
In the beginning, I dreamt that we were having a celebration of some kind. Everybody we knew was there. Musicians, too.
Suddenly, in comes your grandmother Zeitel. May she rest in peace.
Naturally, I went up to greet her. And she said...
A blessing on your head.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
To see your daughter wed.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
And such a son-in-law, like no one ever saw, the tailor Muttle Kanzoil.
Muttle?
A worthy boy is he.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
A pious family.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
They named him after my dear Uncle Mordechai, the tailor Muttle Kanzoil.
A tailor? She must have heard wrong. She meant a butcher.
You must have heard wrong, Grandma. There's no tailor. You mean a butcher, Grandma. name Eliza Wolf.
No! I mean a Taylor Tevye, my great-grandchild, my little Seidel, who you name for me. Muttel's bride was meant to be. For such a match I prayed.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
In heaven it was made.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
A fine upstanding boy, a comfort and a joy, the Taylor Muttel can't soil.
But we announced it already. We made a bargain with the butcher.
But we announced it, Grandma, to our neighbors. We made a bargain, Grandma, with the butcher laser wolf.
No! So you announced it, Tevye. That's your headache. But as for laser wolf, I say to you, Tevye, that's your headache too.
A blessing on your house, mazel tov, mazel tov. Imagine such a spouse, mazel tov, mazel tov. And such a son-in-law, like no one ever saw. The Taylor Muttel Kanzor.
Who's a butcher?
The Taylor Muttel Kanzor.
The laser wolf, the Taylor Muttel Kanzor.
Shot, shot. Look, who is this?
Who is this?
Who comes here?
Who?
What woman is this? My righteous anger shaken.
Yes, it could.
Why not?
Who could be mistaken?
Is the butcher's wife come from beyond the grave? Is the butcher's dear, darling, departed wife? From the Sarah, from the Sarah, from the Sarah, from the Sarah, from the
Sarah. What is this about your daughter marrying my husband?
Yes, your husband.
Would you do this to your friend or neighbor from a Sarah?
From a Sarah.
Have you no consideration for a woman's feelings?
Woman's feelings.
Handing over my belongings to a total stranger.
Total stranger.
How can you allow it? How? How can you let your daughter take my place? Live in my house, carry my keys, and wear my clothes, pearls, how?
How can you allow your daughter to take her place?
Pearls!
House!
Pearls!
Keys!
Pearls!
Clothes!
You wouldn't let it happen.
Let it happen.
Tell me that it isn't true, and then I wouldn't worry.
Wouldn't worry.
Say you didn't give your blessing to your daughter's marriage.
Daughter's marriage.
Let me tell you what will follow such a fatal wedding.
Fatal wedding.
If Saito marries a laser wolf, I pity them both. She'll live with him 3 weeks.
Grandmother Seitel, may she rest in peace, took the trouble to come all the way from the other world to tell us about the tailor, then all we can say is that it's all for the best. Couldn't possibly be any better. Amen.
Amen.
A blessing on my head, mazel tov, mazel tov. Like Grandma Seitel said, mazel tov, mazel tov. We'll have a son-in-law like no one ever saw, the tailor Muttel Kamzoil.
We haven't got the man.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
We had when we began.
Mazel tov, mazel tov.
Well, since your grandma came, she'll marry what's his name?
The Taylor Muttel Kamzoil.
The Taylor Muttel Kamzoil. The Taylor Muttel Kamzoil. The Taylor Muttel Kamzoil.
Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play?
I don't remember growing older. When did they?
When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be this tall?
Wasn't it yesterday when they were small?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the day.
What words of wisdom can I give them? How can I help to ease their way?
Now they must learn from one another, day by day.
They look so natural together,
just like two should be.
Is there a canopy in store for me?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the days.
To tell myself that I had everything, but that was only half true. I had an aim in life, and that was everything, but now I even have you. I have something that I would die for, someone that I can live for too. Yes, now I have everything. Not only everything, I have a little bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for. I used to wonder, could there be a wife to share such a difficult, wandering kind of life?
I was only out of sight.
Who knows tomorrow where our home will be?
I'll be with you, and that's home enough for me.
Everything is right at hand, simple and clear. I have something that I would die for, someone that I can live for too. Yes, now I have everything, not only everything, I have a little bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for.
Goldie, I've decided to give Perchik permission to become engaged to our daughter, Huddle.
What? He's poor. He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
He's a good man, Goldie. I like him. And what's more important, Huddle likes him. Huddle loves him. So what can we do? It's a new world. A new world. Love. Goldie. Do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our daughters getting married and this trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out. Go inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
Goldie, I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children, milked the cow. 25 years, why talk about love right now?
Goldie, the first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. And now I'm asking, Goldie, do you love me?
I'm your wife.
I know, but do you love me?
Do I love him?
Well?
For 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. 25 years my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
Then you love me. And I suppose I love you too. It doesn't change a thing, but even so, after 25 years, it's nice to know. So you are leaving your home to join that hero of yours. But why won't you tell me where he is?
It is far, Papa, terribly far. He was arrested. He is in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? And he asked you to join him in that frozen wasteland and marry him there?
No, Papa, he did not ask me to go. I want to go.
What huddle, baby.
But, Papa... How can I hope to make you understand why I do what I do? Why I must travel to a distant land, far from the home I love? Once I was happily content to be as I was, where I was, close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love. Who could see that a man would come who would change the shape of my dreams? Helpless now I stand with him, watching older dreams grow dim. Oh, what a melancholy choice this is, wanting home, wanting him, closing my heart to every hope but his, leaving the home I love. There where my heart has settled long ago, I must go.
wandering so far from the home I love. Yet there with my love I'm home.
Well, give him my regards, this Moses of yours. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
Papa, God alone knows when we shall see each other again.
Then we will leave it in his hands.
There where my heart has settled long ago, I must go, I must go. Who could imagine I'd be wandering so far from the home I love? Yet there with my love I'm home.
After a lifetime, a piece of paper, an edict from the authorities, and we must all leave our homes.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah all our lives. Wouldn't this be a good time for him to come?
We'll have to wait for him someplace else. Meanwhile, let's start packing.
Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, what have we got here? A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A pot.
A pan.
A broom.
A hat.
Someone should have set a match to this place years ago.
A bench.
A tree.
So what's a stove?
Or a house. People who pass through Anatevka don't even know they've been here.
A stick of wood?
A piece of cloth.
What do we leave? Nothing much. Only Anatevka. Anatevka, Anatevka. Underfed, overworked, Anatevka. Where else could Sabbath be so sweet? Anatevka, Anatevka, intimate, obstinate, Anatevka, where I know everyone I meet. Soon I'll be a stranger in a strange new place, searching for an old familiar face. From Anatevka I belong, in Anatevka, tumble down.